Oh shit, it's recording without the light this time. Alright, hello, internet. Today, you're going to watch probably the world's shittiest description on the tools of skeletal preservation that I use. With that said, I'm still pretty hungover from last night and did not sleep for a few days beforehand. So I haven't really done anything to take care of myself and look like absolute shit. Still got fucking makeup on my face, I just now brushed my teeth. Haven't eaten, had like a cup of water, and my hair is essentially a giant knot, which is why I tied it back. I fucking hate tying my hair back. So yeah, most of the things you're going to see in this video can be surmised from watching me work on other things. I'm extremely camera shy and fuck up constantly. So, there's really no point to this video whatsoever. Little bit about Wasteland Weekend in there, for anyone that does that. Yeah, I also do this shit unscripted, so I have no idea what I'm doing. Pause a lot. And repeat things and skip things. If you really want to know what the fuck I do, just message me and I'll give you an actual tutorial. What I really need from you, if someone could please send me, like, the fresh corpse of an emu. I've always wanted to take an emu and splice its skeleton with some other animals, like a huge fucking ram skull or American alligator, and make a dragon out of it, elongate the tail with like a fucking Burmese python or some shit like that. So it's all like, rah! So if you happen to come across anything like that, I live in Southern California and will do just about anything to get a fresh emo corpse. Emu or emo, I fucking hate emo kids. So, here we go. Without further ado, the shitty video that I just took. Alright, well, hello, and fucking, oh my god. Gonna stop. Hello, internet. Really hoping you can hear me on this. So, I have seen, I have seen Princess Bride far too many times. Which means I have no quarrel telling you that I'm not left-handed. I am filming this left-handed, so we're gonna have some fun. Yeah, I'm probably gonna make a lot of cuts to this shit, or not, because I'm lazy as fuck. Alright, so, my methodology for preserving skeletons of large creatures and sterilizing all the flesh so you can get it under your nails and shit like that takes 3 days, regardless of the size of the animal, provided you're willing to work. Unfortunately, I have the opportunity to prove this to you because one of my fucking pets died. Woo! Yeah, you know, be real careful with blood magic and shit like that. So here's a general synopsis of what the tools I use are. Somewhere over here, probably here, I should have placed one of my large knives. I did not. If you recall from previous videos, it's always better to use someone else's tools, which is why I still use my friend's fucking scalpels from when, he worked at a hospital. It's also his razor, and the majority of these clay sculpting tools are not mine. Well, they are now. I kind of, just kept them. But they were not mine initially. The only thing here that is mine, spare the knife, that is not here, are the manicure set scissors, which are probably the best fucking tool I have. These are not scissors. These are clamps. These are scissors that were given to me by the same guy that gave me that. His name's Waffle. I think his real name's Jacob, but hey, there we go. Alright, so the wire brush is probably one of the better tools we can use. I don't know what it has to do with carving clay and wood, but that's how I got it. We use this to just kind of roll the flesh off the ribs. We also use this side, which is for more finer details and shit. We're gonna use our scalpels a lot and razor blades a lot for a lot of the cuts. The knife is for generally like just cutting off the head. The scissors are generally for like cutting the body cavity and stuff like that. Or getting under flesh and shit like that, because since they're manicure set scissors, which is why I use manicure set scissors, they have a slight curve to them, which allows you to have a finite duration of how long they can take video for. So here's hoping I get this shit done right. I have various size scoops for different scooping things. It's kind of the same thing. You know, this one is good for getting under the skin. Same with this one. These ones are more used for raking flesh off. I generally don't push, we pull. This guy, these two pieces, depending on the size, they're really good for getting the brainstem out. Which one am I fucking using? Oh yeah, and that's kind of similar to what I use this one for too, the poker. But the poker, I also kind of, you know, I'll use this to puncture the eyes before I scoop them out. This one, you know, you go in there, and I use it on larger bones and stuff like that too with the twist. And for bone work, you know, it collects the marrow and hollows it out so you can make like a pipe out of it or something. For those of you that are probably wondering what the fuck I was focusing on earlier, you're not going to like this part. But for those of you that came to this via Facebook, you probably will. So, I never really fully got into talking about Wasteland on the internets. So here's a few things. One, awesome. Awesome. All of these people are cool as fuck. All of these people are cool as fuck. So yeah, hang out with them. For this shit, okay. This was just given to me, so if you're willing to give it out for free, it's obviously worthless. I still haven't really figured out what the USPF does, so if anyone would like 500 of their dollars for a single LCC cap, you will probably find me eventually. I don't remember how I got these. I was told that one was hard. Don't remember. Don't know who these two people are. I loosely remember someone giving that to me, but I don't know who. So if you are one of these three people, or know them, please say something. Once again, we want to use cleaning strength vinegar. It is 6%. That extra percent goes a long way. And hydrogen peroxide. If you get medical grade, you're gonna want to dilute it or use a lot less. But it's better when replicating what someone else is doing to just do what they're fucking doing. Other thing. So, this guy, junk mail. Noah. He had pretty cool fucking thing that he did. He found me during the bounty hunt, but I was fucking bringing my shit to Jugger Camp. So he left me alone and never found me again. I heard people refer to his name, so he was near me a lot and never fucking found me. I need to send him a lot of caps, and I'm not going to get around to doing that for a fucking while. So if you ever see that guy, please give him caps, please give him liquor, and then just hit me up later about repentance.